Welcome to Long Arm Wednesday. Thank you very much for joining us today. We greatly appreciate you hanging out with us in the quilt shop. I've got my crafty pumpkin apron on and we're gonna do some fun stuff on the long arm. So what I had this idea. Hey, you don't know if you gotta try it. It doesn't work, it doesn't work. If it does, fantastic. So I have my backing, which is white, and not that that matters, my batting, and then a background fabric that I have already stitched out a purple web onto. Now I have taken white fabric that you can see here on the GoPro, and I have gridded out, it's not exactly, but it gave me an idea of what I wanted to do. So the 1 inch here represents a 3 inch here, sort of, just so I can kind of get the proportions out. So I gridded it out and I drew it out. So what I want to do is I want to stitch with this beautiful neon green thread. Show the everybody see. You can see how beautiful that is. It's going to be beautiful when we stitch it out. Back to the regular way. And I want to stitch on top of the white, stitch it out, and then trim around. So here I did an example with the a black fabric. I just used my domestic machine to free motion this out. Stitched on the white and then trimmed around it. And it just kind of you're coloring with the thread. So that's my idea for this haunted house. I hope it works. All right, I'm gonna dim the lights and we're gonna get busy. Stick around. Okay, I got it on 12 stitches per inch and I'm gonna do my best to try and follow at least part of this. I have it rolled up so I have more to go on the top part, but at least we can get started here and see how it turns out. Okay. Oh, it's off the belts as well, so I'm controlling it. Now we want to make like fence post, a picket fence. Okay. Now those little, what I've drawn out is just a guideline for me. I'm not going to go make sure I'm sticking to every single line. It's just so I know kind of where I wanted to put things where, but I want to be also free with it too. If things happen, things happen, right? So okay, I want to do this tree. I'm gonna end up echoing over this so many times, like at least 4 times. I want to do more of a spookier tree than what they had there. Okay, so let's come back here. Stitch this one here. Okay, now this is kind of where it starts to begin with the house, okay? And try at the lower steps first. And you don't want them to be perfect. You want some inconsistency with the stitches. That's a thing, but you know, the whole layout. It's just, we're just trying to have some fun. It is supposed to be a haunted-y, kind of rickety old house. Right? Okay, so now we got ourselves some steps. Let's get ourselves front door. How else are the ghosts and the ghouls and the goblins supposed to get in? Open an arch. Okay, come in just a little bit and try and echo that. Try and use the spacing on your foot as your guide. Come up through the middle. This is a double door. You can make it a single door. make any kind of door you like. It's got some interesting decoration here. You can make it look like a big rook, wood door. Make it like a little barn. I would be very interested to see where you guys are getting your inspiration for doing something like this. Scoot over here. I'm gonna come up. I'm gonna do a window. Oh, looks like our thread jumped up over itself here. We got a little loop-de-loop. Okay, so let's pull this down, clip here. We're gonna have to re-thread no matter what. Okay. So let's kind of figure out what happened here. Give that a little tug-a-roni. Nice clean edge back under. Okay. And just in case the bottom didn't break, which it didn't look like it did, we want to start fresh off. Okay. So trim. Because, like I said, I'm going to end up like echoing this probably several times to give it that bulkiness that I'll be looking for. Okay, so we want to retrace. Always bring our bobbin thread up to the top. Okay. We've got like a roof here. Got an X across it, then there's like seriously no coming in. Did we ever listen when we were kids? I think there's always a haunted house on every block. Backtrack here. Here. A little part of the house up here. Here too, an angled window, and then another little kind of curved little window sashing here. Actually, I wanted to try and finish off that entry. Over here. Okay. I'm gonna literally just make my way around this whole project. So I'm gonna keep the GoPro going and turn, I don't know, maybe not, I don't know. Well, we'll figure this out. I've never done such a long video before or something like this. So but I wanna keep going to so you guys can see it in the end. Okay, so get to work.
Thank you. Okay.